Welcome back, guys, to the King of Games video for this month in March. I'm Joning Joe, and once again, I have one of the new box decks, and of course, I decided to incorporate some synchro action. Although the Dimensions of Wisdom box has some contenders, I decided to try something I'm not used to and play the new Maldolce's deck. With the new key card Hoot Cake being a level 3, I comboed it with another new card from the box, Psychic Wheel Eater. I'm just gonna call him Wheel, cause... Anyway, the main combo with Psychic Wheel is to summon him after you use Hoot Cake's effect, and you have the option to synchro with Hoot Cake for a level 6 synchro, or synchro with Pudding Sis for starters, or you can make a level 7 if you decide to get Messenger Lotto out or Magellan, which is the only way to go into Arcanine Edition. Maldolce's can function well by themselves, but with Psychic Wheel, you get an additional swarming component and you get a lot more chances for lethal. Unfortunately, it does lower your consistency a bit because the only card that Psychic Wheel is going to be used with is Hoot Cake, so you need to make sure you have him. So onto the duels. Kind of behind on this first duel right now, but here you're going to see probably the bread and butter play for the deck. Magically, I'm facing Buster Blader's post nerf. He decided to run with balance, but unfortunately, him using Fusion Reserve too early made my Cosmic Cyclone easier, so I knew I was going to hit DNA Surgery or the Fusion. DNA Surgery was the better hit, I think, and he doesn't know I have Offering, so this is pretty much an OTK in the best possible scenario. Offerings proved to be a good card for the deck. This deck really doesn't need to draw. Between the field spell, you're gonna like search and bring back all the monsters that you use. So I'd say it's good at two. Some people run three for added protection, but I didn't feel the need to overextend like that. I did run into Ancient Gears on the first attempt to get the 5-win streak, and Offerings was useless because you happen to have a fortress. But anyway, this is another quick duel. As you can see, two Psychic Wheels isn't the best, but we have Mew, so we do have an OTK. Unfortunately for him, he puts the one set, so we're just gonna get rid of that Econ, and he can have a Sphere Karibo that might pose a threat, but even if he stops the OTK, I'll still be in a good position afterwards. Messenger Lotto is going to search the field spell and my monsters will get a boost, but I'm going to Synchro Summon to get guaranteed lethal for 4,000. Now the important thing to know, I did make this mistake a lot, but you don't want to activate the field spell until after you Synchro Summon. When you Synchro Summon with Maldolce monsters, they do go to the graveyard and their effects will not activate, so when you use the field spell, it'll bounce them back into the deck. It took me a while to like get used to that, but if you have the field spell in your opening hand, it's even better. If you get like one of those crazy hands with Psychic Wheel, Hoot Cake, and some tech cards. But yeah, that's another OTK. The next duel is going to be a little better. This is actually going to be the longest duel of the video. I try to cut the video shorter so we get to the point. I didn't face dinos a lot. They did come every few games or so, and it's an interesting matchup. They're not as bad as they were when they first came out, now that I've learned the matchup, but this hand isn't the best. Like I said, we want to see Hoot Cake with the Psychic Wheel, but luckily we can search Hoot Cake. However, this time I don't search Hoot Cake. I do pause to think sometimes, do I want to search Mew or Hoot Cake? And I go for Mew this time. We have two back row protections, so that does help, but we're just gonna pass for now. The good thing about Mew is he's also a level 3, so he does work with Psychic Wheel as well. Unfortunately, you do need another Maldolce in your hand to make him worth summoning. So I only run one Mew. I did try three before just to maximize the synchro potential, but one is pretty much the magic number that I like to stick with for ratios. We're just going to banish that single back row he has. There was a delay. He does think about it here for a while, so I was panicking slightly. But it turns out it's the Paleozoic that brings back Vanish cards. So not the end of the world. He does have Survival's End in the Grave after he milled it with Morella. So the only thing we can do is force him to use it. And we're going to go into Pudding Sis just to get some attack presence on the board. But unfortunately, if you do have a monster in the graveyard, Pudding Sis does not get an attack buff. So she is stuck at 1000 attack. Her effect is worth using regardless, because she'll get to pop a card as long as she battles a monster. But I go into Inzectron here. Now, this was a duel that I had to explain the chat why I did what I did. So Wheel Leader does pop a monster when you synchro summon, so he was forced to use Survival's End, and Inzectron's effect prevents him from being destroyed on the turn he summoned. But if he activated Survival's End in response to his summon, he can still destroy it. So that was the reason I didn't go into Stardust as well, because all he had to do was Survival's End on Stardust's summon, and Stardust can't use his effect. If I'm wrong, someone correct me, but I'm pretty sure that's how it went. That's why I decided to go for Inzectron and force him to pop Inzectron instead of Pudding. So play Offerings. He's pretty much in like a, looks like he's in a top deck situation. The two cards in his hand, they're probably monsters, but he does set Baby Sarasaurus. So I did face a dinosaur player earlier before this, and I tried to do something slick and use Treacherous on my own monster and his set just to get lethal, but three monsters on board, I don't really need to do that. I'm just going to swing with Pudding Sis so I can pop his Jurassic World and further destroy his chances of a comeback, and we're going to take this win. Okay, we're on duel number four here. They're actually full blind, luckily. When I did attempt to use the deck in Legend, I struggled for a bit in Legend 2. And if you notice, in the first duel I had against Buster Blader, I was on my promotion, so I did struggle with this deck at times. But unfortunately, this match is a disconnect. I don't like disconnects on the 5 win streak, because it doesn't really... Hey, you got lucky on the disconnect, but I do want to showcase the entire 5 win streak, so unfortunately it's here. I have no choice but to live with it. But we do have a decent hand, as you can see. I went for Messenger Lotto because unfortunately Pudding was in the hand. So I did try to think, do I want 2 Pudding Sets in the deck or 2 Messenger Lottos? But those two cards, I gotta mess with the ratios a little bit more. But we're on the 5th duel now. Now, luckily, this isn't a disconnect, and this is against pre-banless Kawaki Meru. So I did suspect it was Kawaki, and I think I told the chat, oh, here we go, I'm going to lose again on my rank-up match. But we do manage to pull out the victory. So he's going to use Diamond Core. He gets a great hand. The only thing he's missing is Maximus. So I guess since he went first, I figured he was holding off on it since he didn't have to use Diamond Core. But we do get a decent hand. He doesn't have back row, so we can get rolling with our bread and butter play. So I already have the field spell in my hand, so going into Messenger Lotto is pretty pointless. So this is, like I mentioned before, when you synchro, you want to use the field spell after you make the synchro, just so you can send the monster back to the deck. Now, the reason I'm like deciding and hesitating on what I want to summon is because I'm trying to find a way to get lethal no matter what. So the thought that entered my mind here was, do I summon Magellan, which is prismatic by the way, and go for Arcanite Magician to try and pop both his monsters in and swing? But there was no chance of lethal. Arcanite Magician drops after you pop cards, so I'm just gonna go for the usual level 6 play and then go from there. I didn't go for Pudding Sis because she doesn't get the attack buff, because Psychic Wheel Leader would have been left in the grave. But I'm just gonna try to clear his board, set Cosmic Cyclone. Now, my biggest worry here was I had a high chance of believing he had Maximus in his hand, and that's why he didn't use Diamond Core's graveyard effect. So there it is. I think he misplayed, or he didn't have Maximus, but we got lucky. I did check his deck and he had 3 Maximus. So that's the King of Games run. Looking at the deck, it's different from most people. Most people run Psychic Wheel at 2 just to lower the bricks, and 2 Pudding Sis maybe, or 2 Muse, 2 Messen Gelato a lot of people run. I might go back to that, but I wanted to see as much synchro action as possible. Skullmeister, he's not in the video, unfortunately, but in Legend 2, he was amazing when it came to stopping Ancient Gears, because that's this deck's worst nightmare, as well as every other deck. But besides that, Messen Gelato, I might bump up to 2, and everything else, I'll try to keep the same. 2 Cosmic Cyclones, back row is pretty much a nightmare for this deck, and you want to do what you can. The life point loss can be a little harder on this deck than most other decks, but getting rid of the back row is important regardless. Enemy controller, because we're playing a synchro deck, but I didn't need protection, so I decided to go with Treacherous as the other semi-limited card. Ticket didn't do enough for me, so I just stuck with the 2 field spells and offerings I explained. Extra deck, 2 level 6s, the best choices I can make, and Ancient Fairy Dragon does get some combos off. Arcanine Magician with Magilene, it's pretty much a toolbox. But thank you for tuning in. Like, comment, and subscribe to my Twitch and YouTube. I'll see you guys with the next video soon. The next box is gonna be my favorite.